Tyler Coston here, Director of Player Development for PGC Basketball. Here today with my man, Jayson Wells. That's Jayson with a Y. He's going to be setting great screens because that's what he does. And I'm going to teach you how you can become dominant scoring off of ball screens like Kyrie Irving. Kyrie Irving has unbelievable handles, agility, and change of speed, and that really helps. But what's more unbelievable is his mind. So we're going to go through five ways that you can be great using ball screens. So Jayson, let me get you to set up a screen here. Here's the first and most important thing that Kyrie Irving does that you probably don't do, is he actually creates an advantage to create a more solid screen. So most young players, they will just telegraph where the screen is, they'll use the screen, allowing their defender to try to blow up the screen, to try to cheat the screen, to try to push you off the screen. Here's the first and most important thing. Make a move before you use the screen. Jayson, let me get you to go back to the elbow. You're gonna actually take a couple steps into the screen. Here's the cool thing about offensive players. Great offense will always beat great defense because you know what you're trying to do and the defense doesn't know. As you're coming down the floor setting up your screen, you know where Jason's gonna set the screen, but the defender doesn't. So if I know that Jayson, don't do it yet, Jayson, is to come set the screen to the inside of the floor. I want to do something, whether it be some sort of a move, a shoulder shake, eye and point, to get my defender leaning away from the screen. Don't just use the screen, set him up first. So as Jayson does start to move into the screen, I want to make a move to get my defender running away from the screen so that when I do come off the screen, I've already created separation. Don't wait for the screen to get separation for you. Create separation so that they have to run solidly into the screen. Kyrie Irving does that incredibly well. Practice how you can do it. Here's the second thing. Slow down. Kyrie Irving is faster than us, but he uses screens slower than most of us. So here's a pro tip that's going to blow your mind. As Jason's setting the screen and he runs into it and I set him up, I don't want to immediately go off of the screen. I want to take what we call a control dribble, to pause before I make contact with the screen. This pause is actually going to give you a read into the future. As you pause, the defender is going to show you how they're guarding the screen. They might jump to the front side of the screen, allowing you to reject the screen and attack off of it. They might get attached and force you off of the screen. It's going to allow you to see how they're guarding it. Don't pause on the screen. After you set them up, pause before the screen. That's going to allow you to split, reject, or make the read coming off of it. Here's a third thing that Kyrie Irving does really well. He actually touches the screener. Now, everyone's told you gotta make contact, you gotta make contact. There's a big difference between knowing something and doing something. Kyrie Irving's great because he consistently does it. Your inability to make contact with the screener usually comes from rushing too early, not setting up your defender, and not pausing before the screen. Basketball is a game of angles. Kyrie Irving is great at using angles. He takes a page out of Wayne Gretzky's book, The Great One, the hockey player. Wayne Gretzky said, "I don't skate to where the puck is, I skate to where the puck is going to be." That's a whole different angle. It's the same thing on the basketball court. Anticipate and get better angles. If I use this screen and I don't make contact, my angle of attack is going to be away from the basket, not putting pressure on the defense. What making contact with the screen does is it allows me to make sure that my angle is downhill, putting pressure on the defense. Make contact with the screen. Reach out and grab the screener. Grab the back of their thigh. Make contact with the screen. Here's the next thing Kyrie does incredibly well. After using the screen, he actually stretches the defense before he attacks. So what most players do is they try to come off the screen, they might make contact, and they try to turn the corner and attack immediately. Kyrie Irving actually puts the hedge defender and the on-ball defender in an uncomfortable situation. Once he makes contact, he stretches the screen out laterally. What that does is it puts a big player in a position where they have to move side to side laterally. They're not very good at that. They can probably body you up if you attack straight into their body. But by stretching them first, you're setting them up for a crossover, another in and out. By stretching them, you make that defender on the ball have to cover more ground as well. Stretch before you attack. Now, here's the fifth and final thing that Kyrie does so well. And for this one, Jayson, we're going to take you from the offensive teammate setting the screen to actually the hedge defender. So let's say that Jayson right now is in a drop coverage. The first thing that Kyrie does really well when the hedge defender is dropped and protecting the rim is Kyrie knows, and take maybe one more step back, like a deep drop, perfect, trying to force a mid-range pull-up. The first thing Kyrie does so well is he doesn't necessarily rely on his speed to create space. He relies even more on contact. We call this a contact pull-up. As his on-ball defender is trailing over top, Kyrie doesn't get into a rush to get away from him. He'll actually dribble back into that defender, bump them off, creating separation. And then as that hedge defender is backing up, he'll pull right up into it. The second thing that he uses incredibly well when that defender's dropping back on him is what we call a downhill pull-up. So this defender is going to probably back up if you dribble fast at them. What he does a great job of is he actually throws the ball out towards that defender like this to get into his pull-up. It gives the illusion of more speed and actually creates separation. So after he stretches, he'll actually throw it out and then go into his pull-up, as opposed to just a straight dribble that allows that defender to really attack the ball more. Here's the last thing that Kyrie does a great job of. When he gets a runway coming off of a screen, he doesn't allow a bigger, stronger defender to dictate his shot at the rim. He knows the secret of nostril time. That basically means when you're trying to finish against a bigger defender, you've got to go at their face and attack right through their nostrils. So he does a great job of, on this attack, if that defender doesn't back up, that defender actually comes, he's going to get into their body early, then he's going to attack away from them, using that contact away from the rim to put that defender on their heels. That's a lot, but it's a lot that makes Kyrie Irving better than most of us at screens.